Okay, hi everyone. So this is our current events assignment focusing on employee rights, which is chapter 9. This group project is done by Nancy, myself, I'm Chris, Katie, and Kaylin. One thing to note just at the outset is this was a group effort to put this slide deck together. As a result of the current situation, we found that it was a lot easier and it came together a lot better to just have one person narrate it. So I'm Chris, I'm going to be doing the narration, but it's important to note that this is a group effort to put this slide presentation together. And our topic today is on off-duty conduct and the employment relationship. Where is the line? So, summary of the article. What this article does is it discusses the issue of employees off-duty either behavior or online behavior and how that can impact the relationship with the company. So in the past, off-duty conduct wasn't something that really had to be dealt with. In the past, there was really no such thing as social media or an online presence. And so this kind of stuff wasn't something that HR departments generally had to think about. But with social media becoming more and more ubiquitous, it's something that is becoming a new issue. So when an employee does something, they say they post something on social media or they act out in some way when they're off duty, and that reflects poorly on the company, how does that place the employer and the HR department, and how should they handle that? So it's kind of an up and coming issue. It's a current events issue in HR, and it's a complicated one. We're going to talk about that today. Another aspect of this is about workplace cyberbullying. So if there is cyberbullying going on in the workplace, even if it's off duty, it's basically the same as if it is on duty. So that's something that employers have to grapple with. So moving on to a bit of an analysis of the article, the real question posed is, can an employer discipline an employee for something done off duty? Now the answer to this is that it kind of depends. It's a bit of a gray area. It's kind of complex and it depends on many variables. So the general rule of thumb is that for an employer to discipline an employee for something that's done away from work, there generally has to be some sort of reasonable link to the employment relationship. So it can't be completely unrelated. One weakness we found in this article that we found a bit strange was that this article starts off describing Don Cherry's dismissal from Hockey Night in Canada relating to comments he made on that program as the lead example. And it's a bit strange to make that a lead example because for an article that's mostly about off-duty behavior, Don Cherry's comments that he was dismissed for were made on the camera on Hockey Night in Canada doing his job. So bit of a disconnect there, but that's just one thing we found about the article, is a slight disconnect between using Don Cherry as an example of this because his conduct was very much at work on his job. So digging into a bit more of the details here, the bottom line is that what an employee posts online or does off-duty can sometimes impact an employer's reputation. And if off-duty conduct does harm the reputation of the company can take action. So over in the right here is an example we found that's pretty interesting. So this is from just last year. Two Vancouver police officers are facing disciplinary hearings from their employer, the police service, for their conduct in Cuba. So interesting thing here is that these officers were not only off duty, but they were off duty and out of the country, and relating to a situation in Cuba where they were accused of an assault, they are facing disciplinary hearings right back with their employer in Vancouver. So this is a good illustration that these days it's not only off duty conduct, when you're just away from the workplace, this is off duty conduct in another country that's coming back and the employer is feeling they have to deal with it. This is kind of particularly an important case of when it's a high public profile job with a high public trust individual such as police officers. This is especially important. In this article, it cites the law, and actually the according to the BC Police Act, a police officer is guilty of misconduct if they commit any misconduct. Doesn't matter if it's on duty or off duty, they are guilty of that misconduct and face disciplinary measures. So something to think about. Further on in the article, this article does is it discusses a bit about policies that the HR department is kind of going to be responsible for to put together to kind of deal with this issue. So one of the main things is that the employer, to get ahead of this issue, really needs to lay down clear expectations and guidelines for employees about how they're behave online and away from work. These are two questions we were going to hope to engage the class a little bit and have a bit of a classroom discussion on. Obviously, that's not really possible given the venue for this, but these are questions to think about anyway. How do you feel about your employer dictating how you use social media when you're not at work? And what do you think of a company that has an HR person monitoring your off-work behavior? So I know we can't discuss it in person here at this time, but it's these are interesting questions and it's something to think about. So in terms of demands on human resource department, like we said at the outset, this originally, 20 or so years ago, before kind of the explosion of the online environment, this wasn't really something that HR departments had to think about or deal with. But now, where most or all employees have social media, this is something that that HR departments definitely have to grapple with. One of the first things they have to do is they have to get a set of policies together. Employee conduct, how employee usage is going to be monitored, how any issues are going to be responded to. It raises a bunch of questions about how this should be best managed and what the best practices are. Generally, if we find that being proactive is a good idea on this instead of just reactive, and also laying out disciplinary procedures if there is off-duty conduct or online conduct that is not appropriate. In terms of how to actually discipline an employee, it does have to be justified and has to be lawful, and that's a conversation the HR department also has to be involved in around the disciplinary procedures to make sure they are properly documented and lawful. So in terms of possible solutions or recommendations to how to best deal with this, one of the things we found looking at both the article and some other examples of how other companies deal with this is it looks like the best way to deal with employee conduct off duty and online is really to have a proactive approach. So it's much better to have a set of guidelines in place so that employees are clear about online behavior, expected off duty behavior, rather than being reactive. So it makes a lot more sense to have the guidelines down and ready to go. So that everybody's clear about kind of the expectations. That's a lot better than just reacting to an incident. That puts the company on the back foot, and that doesn't seem like a good way to go. So one of the examples that we really liked for a social media policy was from Intel, the technology company. We liked it because Intel seems to have a really clear and straightforward policy for online activities. It's made up of these three rules of engagement down here in the bottom right. The first is just to disclose that you work from Intel, so don't post them anonymously. Protect yourself and protect Intel, so just understand that when you are online, you're representing not only yourself, but you're representing Intel as well. And the third one we really liked, which is just use common sense and kind of be professional. And if posting something seems a bit doubtful, it's better just not. You know, if it seems a bit like it might not be a good idea, it's better just not to not hit send on that tweet. So we really liked this. We thought that this was one of the rules, the social media rules we really liked. It was just, it's clear, it's concise, it's simple. It's not a huge multi-page document. It's something that all employees can kind of understand, and move forward with. So this is an example that we really liked. This is another thing I wanted to bring up for a bit of a class discussion. Obviously, again, not possible in given that we're not meeting in person here, but it's something I'd like everyone to think about. So on the right here is a tweet from Daryl Morey. He's the general manager of the Houston Rockets, the NBA team, and he sent this tweet in October of 2019. So this tweet really ticked off the communist government in China, and as a result, Daryl was forced to delete and apologize. Because of the reaction of the government in China, the NBA brand and reputation did suffer because of this, and there was a kind of a loss of value in terms of NBA merchandise and the ability of the NBA to operate in the Chinese market. And so one kind of question I was going to pose to the class and open up to a bit of discussion was, should companies that do business with a country like China adopt the standards of the Communist Party of China when it comes to employees expressing opinions online? You know, that's something to definitely consider. And it's a kind of an interesting example of this, the idea of employee online behavior and how that impacts the employer. So that brings us to our references. That's it for the presentation. On behalf of myself, Katie, Nancy, and Caitlin, thanks for listening, and take care.